Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. There was a man by the name of Abdullah al-Najashi. He was the ruler of the area known as Ahwaz in modern-day Iran during the time of Imam Jafar ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhi. Now, he was known for his taqwa, God consciousness, for his devotion to the school of Ahlelbayt and obedience to Ali Muhammad. One day, there was an individual who lived in that area of Ahwaz. He happened to meet Imam al-Sadiq in Madinatul Munawwara. That person went to Imam al-Sadiq and said to him that I am unable to pay the taxes. Can you write a letter to the ruler and the governor of Ahwaz so that he can maybe help me? Imam al-Sadiq wrote a wonderful letter. In it, there was one sentence after Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The sentence said, Surra akhak yusirruka Allah. Please your brother, Allah will please you. That's all that the sentence said and the letter included. So the man takes this letter to Ahwaz. Upon reaching, he knocks on the door. The servant of the governor comes out and says, can I help you? He says to her that I have come with a letter from Ja'far al-Sadiq, peace be upon him. Upon hearing the beloved name of the Imam, this individual, the governor, rushes out. It is said that he was barefoot. He comes out and he welcomes this particular individual. When he was given the letter, he embraced it, kissed it, and placed it on his forehead, then read it. Upon which he ordered that the name of this man from the list of those who have to pay taxes is erased. Not only this, he gave him a horse, he gave him a servant, gave him some money, some clothing. In fact, even the rug that that individual was sitting on was gifted to him. And every time this Abdullah al-Najashi, the governor of Ahwaz, would give this man something, he would say, are you pleased? Are you pleased? And the man would say, of course, I'm very, very pleased. When he left, that individual was full of delight and joy. He went eventually to meet Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam and tell him of how the governor of Ahwaz had treated him. When Imam heard this, he smiled. The man looked at him and says, oh, the grandson of the Holy Prophet, you must be delighted. You seem very happy. The Imam alayhi salam then replied, Ay wallah, by God I am. لَقَدْ سَرَّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. He has made Allah and His Messenger happy. Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, like all the Imams of the Ahlul Bayt and the Prophets, the chosen individuals by the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, were the champions of acts of kindness. They would encourage their followers to do good, to help others, to improve the lives of others, to fulfill the wishes of others. Once this governor wrote a letter to Imam al-Sadiq, asking for instruction, wanting for guidance and direction. He says that I'm in a difficult position governing this particular land. I want some illumination of the heart from you. Imam writes him a wonderful instructive letter full of gems and treasures. And amongst the things that Imam al-Sadiq actually mentions to this particular individual is with regards to serving others and improving their lives. The Imam alayhi salam goes to say, وَمَنْ قَضَى لِأَخِيهِ الْمُؤْمِنْ حَاجَةً. If you fulfill a deed for your believing brother or sister, قَضَى اللَّهُ لَهُ حَوَائِجَ كَثِيرًا. Allah will fulfill many needs for you. أَحَدُهَا الْجَنَّةِ. One of them would be paradise. Today, if you are in need, or if you have some wishes to be fulfilled, one of the effective ways is to help others, is to do whatever you can to improve the lives of others or come to the help of others as it's instructed and encouraged and practiced by our holy sixth Imam, Ja'far al-Sadiq. Peace and blessings be upon him.